Morning. Political candidates breaking the law before ever even taking office.
It doesn't matter what party, PennDOT says they're all guilty. News 8's Morning reporter Caitlin Smith live in Lancaster County to explain. Caitlin, good morning.
Good morning, Lori and Jerry. We are talking about the rules regarding removing signs like this, these political signs. Now, most townships in the Susquehanna Valley require candidates remove them within 7 days, but PennDOT says it ends up picking up the slack.
It's just a hassle for us.
PennDOT workers spend about 2 hours a week this time of year picking up after political candidates.
You always got to be watching yourself for traffic, especially along a busy highway like this.
And busy highways are one place signs like this are never allowed to be, not even before the election. Interstates and ramps are supposed to be off limits, yet PennDOT yanks out hundreds of signs here every year. The signs pile up at PennDOT salt sheds for about 30 days, giving candidates a chance to come claim them. Unfortunately, those who do usually turn into repeat offenders.
You'll pick them up, and then a week later they'll be back. So then you'll go back and pick them up again, and then they'll be back.
And if the candidates or campaign workers don't pick them up, this is where they end up, in the dumpster.
But what ends up happening to the candidates? Not much. In most townships in the Susquehanna Valley, candidates have 7 days to take the signs down. Some places, like Susquehanna Township and Lower Paxton Township, require a $100 deposit to put signs up. You don't get it back until they're all down. As of Friday morning, only one candidate was not in compliance, Judge Andrew Dowling. By that afternoon, his name was cleared. The PennDOT workers we talked to weren't sure what kind of fines candidates could face. They just know what might happen to them.
My penalty is getting fired maybe, but not sure.
And so they'll continue to momentarily put regular road maintenance on hold in order to help candidates clean up.
Never-ending process.
Now, we did try contacting all of the candidates whose signs you saw there in that story. Only two returned our calls. Andrew Dowling was one of them. He refused to go on camera, but says he does believe candidates should take responsibility for taking those signs down. He says, frankly, it's just hard to keep track of them. Chris Judd also returned our call. He said that his campaign workers were out actually on election night going by and taking down all the signs. He says the one that we caught on camera wasn't even in his district, so he didn't even know it was there. Lori, Jerry, it sounds like this is going to be an ongoing thing.
Because a lot of people just pick up those signs and put them up, and it's hard to keep track of them all. I can see that point, too.
True. Yeah. All right, Caitlin, thank you.